Do you know your why? I want to talk to you a little bit today about why you do what you do, whether it's starting a business, whether it's creating a new habit, whether it's losing weight, whether it's learning a new skill, whatever it is, why do you want to do it? My name is Jessica Stortz with Stortz Wellness Associates and an independent Checkley distributor, and I can't tell you how important your why is. Whenever you start, no matter what it is, times are going to get tough. Things are going to get difficult. You're going to want to quit at some point, or you're going to fall back into old habits. So you have to have something to anchor you into why you are doing what you're doing so that you will stay the course. So the first thing you do is come up with why you're wanting to do what you do, and then you're penning it on paper. My goal is to live a longer, healthier life, and I want to be around for my kids in my older age. I wanted to maximize my time, my health, and my finances because I want to live intentionally now, not later in life. So that is why I do what I do, and I always come back to those things when times get tough. The other thing would be to surround yourself by people that are like-minded and that are going to motivate you and help you reach your goals. You're going to need people to tell you that you're doing a good job and to keep going. You don't want those naysayers in your life that are saying, you want to lose 30 pounds? How are you going to do that? Look at how you eat. Or really, you're going to try that new diet? That's just crazy. You want people that are going to support you no matter what you choose. The other thing you can do is listen to podcasts or videos or things that motivate you, but you have to do it on a regular basis and a lot of times daily. As a Christian, they tell us to be in God's word daily so that we can develop that practice and that habit because they know that the world gets tough. Well, just like that, if you're wanting to lose weight, you got to get into what's going to motivate you to do that. Surround yourself by people that are doing that and listen to positive things or things that get you excited about losing weight again. You can also cut pictures out of magazines for your wants and needs and maybe a picture of what you used to look like if you were previously thin or maybe somebody you aspire to look like so that you can remind yourself of that's what you're wanting to do. You can also, if you're looking to start a new business opportunity and maybe your goal is to finish your basement or to be able to buy a new car or be able to take a vacation, you can cut out pictures of that and have it on your refrigerator or somewhere where you're going to see it. So every time you go by it, you're reminded, this is why I'm doing what I'm doing. This is why I'm on this business venture, even when the going gets tough. And lastly, you want to create new habits. Old habits die hard, don't they? Like sometimes we sleep in till 8 o'clock every day, and maybe we're late for work. Well, we got to create a new habit. Maybe we get up at 6 every day and we keep going. Does that mean we're going to be perfect all the time? No, we might fail, but the point is that we get back up and that we keep going. So I want to encourage you to write down your goals and why you're doing what you're doing. Surround yourself by people that are positive. Listen to positive and encouraging things, and also create new habits. I hope all these things will help you live a longer, healthier life.